Like you said, it's not the coffee that makes you fat, but all the extras that go with it, from lattes to espressos, mochas, and cappuccinos. These souped-up coffee drinks are prepared with milk, cream, added sugars, and syrups. Some contain enough calories and sugar to make a fast food meal look like a light snack. But if you can't give up your gourmet cup of joe each morning, here are a few changes you can make to satisfy your taste buds without all the added calories.
It's really as simple as ordering that plain old cup of black coffee. Just pour the extras in yourself. For example, a tablespoon of chocolate syrup has about 50 calories and will satisfy your taste buds as much as the 16 tablespoons or 800 calories that come in some large specialty coffees. But if you must order those specialty beverages, order ones made with milk like cappuccinos or lattes, and ask for skim. Skim milk will cut 50 calories or more depending on the size of your drink.
Would you like any whipped cream on your mocha?
No, thank you. You know, another great way to trim 100 calories and several grams of fat is to say no to the whipped topping. Thank you.
And less is more when it comes to preventing weight gain, so order a smaller size. For example, an 8-ounce cup cafe mocha has 200 calories and about 11 grams of fat. You don't have to be a mathematician to know that if you double the size, you double the calorie and fat intake too. Yuck. It's really all about educating yourself. If you have a favorite gourmet coffee drink and don't know the calorie or fat count, check out the nutritional content online. Knowing what you're putting into your body is often motivation enough to cut back.
Now, once in a while, you probably should have that fully dressed specialty coffee drink, as long as you treat it like you would any other indulgence, such as a slice of chocolate cake. It's not something you have on an everyday basis.